First, I would like to tell you that I meet a lot of people being concerned about AI. What is my data used for? Will I lose my job? And in this digital world, watching the news, is this for real? It's just fake. There's a lot of concerns, and I can share them together with you. But it shouldn't prevent us also from thinking about how can we create the good life together with AI. I'm an algorithm professor with a background in philosophy, and I've been thinking a lot about this. How do we create the good life with AI? I will start with a little example about a self-driving car. Try to imagine that we will have a self-driving car being even better than a human being driving a car. Should we then let people drive cars? Well, knowing, you know, more traffic accidents will happen and more people will be killed in traffic? That is a question. When I think about my neighbor, for sure, he shouldn't be allowed to drive. No way. What about me? Yes, you can let me drive. I'm really good and I love to drive. No, joke aside. But this example is illustrating for us, as machines and AI are getting better and better, we will have to make some decisions. What should we allow the machines to do? And what should we allow people to do? And it's not clear, not at all. Let's take one more example. And this is also with a self-driving car. It's really far out example, and it's not my example, but it's a well-studied example, so let's go for it. And what we are looking at here is a self-driving car coming into this unfortunate situation that it either have to kill a baby or a grandma. I'm sorry. Which one? It's not my idea, this example. Who should it kill? Studies show that in some countries, people are saying, let's save the baby. But in other countries, people are saying, let's save, you know, the grandma. People have different preferences. Yeah. Also, we have some people are saying that before we can accept having self-driving cars and allow them, we really need to have all these questions answered. What should the car do here? The interesting thing is that we can actually, with machines and AI in advance, design them to a specific behavior. And that is the reason why these questions are popping up. If you're looking around the world, I don't find any law saying, what should a human being do? Kill the grandma, kill the baby. And it wouldn't make sense, right? But with AI and machines, we can subtly take this kind of decision. And this is why it makes sense. It didn't surprise me, not at all, that the studies were showing that people have different preferences. When I think back to my early days being a little boy, actually maybe that little here, and I was watching the TV here, and I was seeing the news that people could do terrible things to each other just because of having different skin colors. Is people born like that? Is it raised like that? I don't know, but I didn't like it. And I decided for my life, being a small kid, that, hey, I want to live, you know, in a fair world, and I want to contribute to that. Yeah? I want to have that we treat people equally. But even having made that decision, later on in my life, I had two small kids, and a daughter and a son. And I could see myself speaking to my son, saying, hey, you're a strong little boy, quite often. And to my daughter, I was saying that, hey, you're a pretty little girl, right? So what I'm doing here is that I'm actually feeding into the ideas that a girl should be pretty and a boy should be, you know, strong. Even I don't want to do this kind of things. And when I think of my life, I'm most likely, you know, being biased many, many, many times. People are biased and we are without really knowing it. What about machines? Yes. I'm sorry to say, machines can also be biased, especially if they are copying human behaviors. But now we come to the good part. And the good part is that with machines, we can quite often, overnight, take the bias out of them, or at least minimize it to something very little. That is nice. Can we do the same thing with human beings? maybe it could take years, maybe it's impossible, right? So having AI and machines can really help us to reduce the bias in the life we are living, sometimes by letting the machines make the decisions, and maybe sometimes, you know, having a little alarm. Hey, Stephen, you are biased. Don't talk to your daughter and son like that. Okay, I agree. But this is not the only thing AI can do for us. And there's a really important concept called confidence score. The confidence score is that AI is telling us something, but also how sure it is. So if I take a picture of an apple, and I show it to a machine, and I ask the machine, is this an apple or a banana? It will tell me, hopefully, that this is an apple. But it will not only tell me it is an apple, it will also give me a confidence score, how sure it is. That is useful. So let's plan for a picnic. I want to go to a picnic. Let's look at the forecast. It's going to rain. Maybe we cancel. But look here, it says, you know, it's only 10% chance for it's going to rain. So this is, you know, it will rain, and the confidence score, how likely it is. And we combine the information, and then we make a decision. 10%, let's go for the picnic. I take the chance. Let's try to jump into the future, and we will go and visit our AI doctor. It's a clever one, really clever one. And I'm telling about my symptoms, looking at my medical history, and you know, all my test results, and so on. And what is happening is that, and then the AI say, you know what? You could have this disease here, and here's your confidence score, how likely it is. That's nice. Because, you know, the machine is saying to me, there's only 0.0001% chance you have the disease. I don't care. But when we're talking to a human being, then we don't get this confidence score. I mean, it's very rare, at least. I've not experienced it. We get a gut feeling, you know, based on my experience, I feel, and so on. And I go home, and I'm still a little bit concerned, right? How sure was this guy? Was he telling me the truth? Yeah. I don't know. But getting, you know, the confidence score here, I can, as a non-expert, I can be involved in the decision. What should happen here now? Is it high enough so it's worth, we should do something, or should we just drop it, right? That's nice. It's transparent and I understand it. Furthermore, we can use it to ensure that we are treating people equally. You can go to this AI doctor and you could go to this AI doctor, and you know what? If you get an investigation more in deep, yeah, that is because the confidence score you're getting out here is above a given threshold, and the same. And even the decision made here, we can take the bias out. It's super nice. What I'm trying to illustrate to you here is that with the digitalization of our world and the AI, we are stepping into a new world. And when we are doing this, there will be a lot of decisions we can make. What should a human be doing? What should a machine be doing? How sure should we be on something before we use a lot of money on it? And so on, and so on. But we should not aim for having all the questions answered. Should we kill the baby or the grandmom? Because we have an infinite pool of questions out there. So we will never be finished. And we shouldn't aim for having the perfect AI. That's impossible. Nothing in the world is perfect. I mean, if a doctor tomorrow are making mistakes, we will not say that no doctor is allowed to work tomorrow in the whole world. Stop. And think about my neighbor, the bad driver. If he's involved in a traffic accident, we will not stop all cars for driving tomorrow and say no one can drive, right? This is not the way we behave. What we're asking ourselves is that, and we should ask ourselves with AI, can we make the world a little bit better tomorrow using AI? That is the right question. Let's try to jump back again to this AI doctor here in the future. When I visited him, and he was a clever guy, and I really want him to be clever, right? He will only be clever if a lot of people have been donating, sharing the data, the medical history, with the AI doctor, because we built AI on top of data. So thank you to all you people out there in sharing your data to the AI doctor here in the future, such that it recognizes very fast if I have a disease so I can get a cure. Thank you. But let's stop and think a little bit. I was saying some people have been sharing the data. Who's these young people? Oh, it could be me, or it could be you. That's for sure. If none of us is sharing our data, I mean, we will not get this smart AI doctor. So we need to share the data. I would love to share my data for the good purpose. You know, if I can help save life, maybe my family life, maybe a stranger's life, that's nice. We already today, or at least many of us is today, sharing our data with the big tech companies. That can be a little scary. It could be, you know, the location where we are to avoid traffic jam. If we do this, the big tech companies know where you are, who you're meeting with, what you like, your photos, and what you eat, and all kind of stuff. They use it for many different things. They can also use it for example, to show you an advertising for a product you need even before you knew it, right? That's scary. I think it's spooky. Whoa, do I need this? What about sharing your data, you know, to save life? The same data. Such that maybe, you know, you could be told that, hey, you have a disease, we have a cure for it. Yeah, that's pretty nice, even before you knew it. That would be nice. But then we have actually some people saying, no, 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 Stephen, we cannot allow people to share the data here. Yeah, that's not okay. People are too stupid. You're too stupid, you're too stupid, you're too stupid, everybody. And I'm like, you know, where I'm come from, when I die, I can donate my organs. I can give my money to charity and so on. But you're saying I shouldn't be allowed to share my data for good purpose? Whoa. What else I'm not allowed to? What else I'm too stupid to? I'm too stupid to decide who I'm going to marry, who to vote on. You know, I think this is really scaring what you're talking about here, that I'm not allowed to share my data for the good purpose here. That's scary. That's really scary. We have also some people saying that, Stephen, please stop now. Data ethics is about being for machines or against machines. Now you have to make a decision. And I'm just like, hey, come on, it's not about that. If we look into what is ethic about, the last time I was looking into the dictionary, it was about how do we create the good life. So talking about data ethic, that must really be about how do we create the good life with data, right? And I believe, you know, sometimes you shouldn't share your data and we shouldn't use AI. No, don't do it. But sometimes we should share our data and we should use AI to reduce bias and to get a more equal world. So the question is, how do we create the good life with AI? Thank you.